Glory to God. Yet again, we are doing a new broadcast today, and we want to deal with the subject of depression. This week, we've had so many different people to send in prayer requests dealing with the spirit of depression and wanted to get healed, set free, and delivered. And as I begin to seek the Lord as to what to speak on as it relates to depression, he took me to a great passage of scripture. 2 Kings, the 7th chapter, starting with the 3rd verse through the 8th verse. 2 Kings 7, 3 through 8. And the Bible says, "Now there were 4 leprous men at the entrance of the gate, and they said to one another, 'Why are we sitting here until we die? If we say we will enter the city, the famine is in the city, and we shall die there. If we sit here, we die also. Now, therefore, come, let us surrender to the army of the Syrians. If they keep us alive, we shall live. If they kill us, we shall only die.' And they rose at twilight to go to the camp of the Syrians. And when they had come to the outskirts of the Syrian camp, to their surprise, no one was there. For the Lord had caused the army of the Syrians to hear the noise of chariots and the noise of horses, the noise of a great army. So they said to one another, 'Look, the king of Israel has hired against us the kings of the Hittites and the kings of the Egyptians to attack us.' Therefore, they arose and fled at twilight and left the camp intact, their tents, their horses, and their donkeys, and they fled for their lives." Verse number 8, "And when these lepers came to the outskirts of the camp, they went into the tent and ate and drank and carried from every tent silver and gold and clothing and went and hid them. Then they came back and entered into yet another tent and carried some from there also and went and hid it." And as I begin to see God about, again, the spirit of depression has hit this earth and that so many people are struggling with, and he led me to the scripture, the 4 lepers. Understand, all 4 were diseased, they were in despair, and they felt ostracized from the entire city. They were on the outside longing to be on the inside. We have all been there when issues in our lives seem to keep us from fitting in and going to the next level or place. These lepers were in a serious dead zone, if you will. They had counted the cost, and for them they thought that death was the only option. But thank God for the option of life. There is always an option of life. There is always a life option, no matter what you're going through right now, no matter how bad it seems, always know that there is a life option for you. They either had strength to lie there and die, or strength enough to get up and try. They decided to go despite what they were going through and what they had been through in life. Understand this. These lepers were clueless to a degree, but they were careful and not careless about the next move in their lives. Hear me today, if you're battling a mental illness or you're battling depression, be careful and not careless about the next move in your life. The Bible says in Proverbs 19:16, "He who is careless of his ways will die." Don't be careless about your life. God has a plan and a destiny for you. Do not allow the enemy to rob you of your life. There has to be consistency and diligence in all your ways. They all asked the paramount question, "Why are we just sitting here?" The lepers, they looked from the left to the right, all 4 of them, and they said, "Why are we sitting here?" Today I pose that question to you. Why are you just sitting there, sitting on your dreams, your talents, your breakthrough, your life, your family, when so much more awaits you? Do not sit there, but allow the spirit of the living God to breathe on you today, and he is speaking life into you. He is breathing life into you. He is strengthening you with life more abundantly. Do not be afraid to move and make a decision in this season. You could be wrong, yes. The odds are against you, but you still owe it to yourself to at least try. I am telling you today, don't sit and die, but you need to get up and go and try. Understand, the lepers had three choices. Number one, they could go back to the city in the famine and die. Number two, sit and die. Or number three, go to the enemy, surrender, and possibly die. Now, to the naked or the untrained eye, you would say all the choices equal death. However, the third choice, the most unpopular choice, and the least traveled road only had the possibility of death for these lepers in 2 Kings chapter 7. The other two choices had the assurance of death. Choice number one and number two gave them the options to sit and do nothing or turn and go back to where they had just come from. Sit and do nothing and turn back are never the choices that God has for us today. I want to say that again. Sit and do nothing, or even turning back, going back to the very place God has delivered us from, is not the choices that God has for us today. He never wants you to just sit and be stagnant, nor does he want you to go back to a place that you've already been delivered from. That's why when he delivered the Israelites out of Egypt, he closed the Red Sea behind them so they would not turn back around and go back into slavery. Don't go back into bondage today. No matter what that bondage is, especially if you're in bondage in your mindset or in a relationship or whatever seems to have you in a stronghold, don't go back and do not sit there and die. In verses 5 through 6, when they decide to make a move, God made one as well. Their little steps, their little footsteps walking to the enemy's camp were undetectable, but God amplified the sound to such a degree that their enemies heard chariots, horses, and a great army coming. I want you to visualize that with me, seeing these four lepers, scared, terrified, almost at the point of death, just pretty much out of their mind, you know, out of options, in a dead zone, in a bad place, making their footsteps. And I bet they were just taking it very slow, not realizing that the enemy, every time they took a step, God amplified the sounds of their steps so that the enemy that they thought they were going to have to surrender to heard chariots, horses, and a great army coming. What seems to be small footsteps in your eyes is a great amplified sound that God is doing a miracle in your life. And the very enemy that you thought was going to have you bound, the Lord is getting ready to send a great sound, an alarm to your enemy to let him know he has to loose you and let you go today. I know you feel like that what's going on in your life is causing you so much pain, but if you could change your perspective about the pain that you're going through, it's just a process of God perfecting you today. Where you are today is not where you will always be. I promise you that. And you have to understand that just like the lepers, you too have to take the first step. They had to make a step, then God amplified that step that they made. I promise you that if you would step out in faith today and get out of the pit that you're in, God will make a move on your behalf. Come on, not doing something is still disobedience. Some of us are scared of moving out, thinking we're going to do the wrong thing, but sitting still is still disobedience. Because they decided not to die and not to give up and not to allow depression to overtake them, the Bible says that when they got to the enemy's camp, that they came empty-handed, but they left full and overflowing with clothing, with food, with silver, and with gold. When you trust God, you will not be left empty-handed. The lepers even went back to the same place and the same people that had put them out and left them for dead in order to tell them about all the great things that God had done in their lives. If you continue reading that chapter, and I admonish you to do that, to read the entire chapter of 2 Kings chapter 7, you will see that the four lepers went back to the very people that put them out to show them the great things that God had done in their lives. I tell you that we too have to go back and save those who are dying. Once God has healed, set free, and delivered us from our issues, especially from depression. And I'm telling you today, that depression is not going to take you out. That depression is not going to be the end of you. But God is giving you a new beginning today so that you can be a living testimony and help somebody else to come out of their depression. We're in a dying world today. But how many of us are actually going into the world saving others, sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. You don't have power till you've empowered somebody else. If you feel powerless today, then I encourage you to empower somebody else. How? By helping them to become enlightened to the better way of Jesus Christ. It is only through the enlightening power of Jesus Christ that we can be activated to go to the next level. I want you to know that small changes equal big transformation. The little things lead to great things. And before I close today, God also laid it on my heart about this word wholeness. And we've been dealing with the word wholeness all week long. And everybody knows what we've been saying, that wholeness means to be completely intact, not to be broken, impaired, not to live a life that is peaceless, but that is peaceful. And that is our prayer for you today if you're dealing with depression. You have to understand that the opposite of happiness and joy is depression. When someone is depressed, they feel devalued, they feel sad, they feel oppressed by life. This way of thinking and these feelings bring you down and lowers your self-esteem. For something to be put or pressed down, then it has to be at a point or a high place of elevation of joy, acceptance, and happiness. I want you to remember, you haven't always been in a depressed state. You haven't always battled that mental illness. There was a time in your life where there was joy and acceptance. No matter what it was that happened in life, the event, the incident that almost stripped you of your mindset, I pray right now that you would receive the power of a sound mind today. I tell you that you can't be depressed or lower yourself any longer. You have to start speaking words of life. Don't speak death over yourself. Speak life. I'm telling you to live again, not just to be alive, but to live again, to dream again, to pursue after God like never before. Depression is a hole, and no one sows into a hole. When you feel that way, you feel like someone is throwing you into a deep pit and that you've been thrown there to die. Today, your emotions, your life, everything that you've been dealing with is coming out of the pit today. It's coming out of the hole. I tell you today, don't stay in a place that will cause you to die, but get in the position that will cause you to live. Get around people that are positive. Get around people that are pursuing God. Get even counseling if you need it. If you need to go to a psychologist or to a pastor or to a minister, please know that we are praying for you and we're believing God that this day when you hear this message, that you'll be just like those lepers who thought that they were going to die but yet decided to take a step. And not only did they take a step of faith, but God gave them a step of life. He amplified their faith when they took a step to believe God that they would not die. A hole swallows somebody up. It tries to come to cover you up. Don't be covered up any longer. Don't suffer in silence any longer. The enemy is using the isolation against you. But God is saying, come out from wherever you are. Come out into an open place so that you do not have to suffer in silence. One of my favorite quotes is by Senator Ted Kennedy. Right before he died, he said this: even the most profound losses are survivable. You can survive even the most profound losses in life. This man, who could speak about losses and hardships despite his politically powerful name, the main point is that through it all, he maintained a can-do attitude and he was a survivor. My brother, my sister, you have losses, but you are not one of them. Outlive your losses today. I want you to know that you are not crazy. You just had a bad day or a couple of bad days, but you are not crazy. God is stabilizing you right now in the name of Jesus. He's rectifying your mind. He's giving you the mind of Christ. I come against everything that will cause your mind to be in a battlefield. But we prophesy to you today. We decree and declare that you shall live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. And you shall have a sound mind. You shall not live in fear. You shall not be afraid. You shall not live as an outcast, but you shall be hallelujah, a fulfillment of the promise of God that you shall have life and have it more abundantly. So we thank God today for your deliverance and your healing, that God is setting you free today, right now. We thank God that you have made the choice to live. We thank God that while you're listening to this prayer and this prophecy, that you're standing up in faith and you are making a bold move for God. You are stepping out just like those four lepers. And as you're stepping out, God is amplifying the sound of your footsteps of faith. Everything that you thought was going to take you out, we thank God now that it is under your feet. Hallelujah. You're walking over the things that you thought were going to be the very things that were going to take you out. We thank God for the authority that you feel right now rising up in the inside of you, the strength and the power that's coming against the weakness that the enemy is trying to place on you. Oh, we thank God right now that your words, hallelujah, are words of life, words that are positive, words that are good, words that are noble. We thank God right now that he's regulating your mind. Hallelujah. We thank you that you have the thoughts of Christ. We thank you that you will meditate upon the word of God. We bless God today that this is your day and you shall rejoice because God is giving you new life and a new beginning. A new lease on life is coming to you today. Receive it by faith and believe it. And we thank God. He's going to give you resources of people to love you and to comfort you and to help you through everything that you're going through. But today, we thank God that you've made a choice that you want to live for God and that you do not want to die, but that you want to live. And that today, you've made a step of faith to go after your destiny. And that everybody that hears your testimony shall be saved, set free, and delivered in Jesus' name. We want to tell you that we love you today and that God loves you and that there's nothing that you're facing today that God cannot heal in Jesus' name.